Filing in, we have an entire row of seats right here that's available. We have four seats over here that are available, so please don't be shy. We're a packed house tonight. Okay, so thank you for being here. First, I want to say hello to all of our friends in South Korea who are watching on our live stream. Thank you so much for watching and being with us.
안녕하세요, 청주대학 여러분. 진심으로 환영합니다.
And this is more of a long speech now. I want to welcome you all to William Paterson Music Department's Vocal Area's Fall 2022 Song Evening. This semester, we are performing Korean language songs. Okay. I should also introduce myself. My name is Christopher Herbert. I'm the Vocal Area Coordinator. And this is Ji Hyun Lim, one of our professors of voice. Okay. So this evening came about with one of our fantastic students, Jessica Momanyi, came to my office and asked, why do we only sing songs in European languages in this department? And I didn't have a good answer. I truly didn't have a good answer. It's a difficult question, and there are both an easy answer and a hard answer. The easy part of the answer is that traditional classical singing grows out of Europe. That's where the tradition comes from. And so the majority of the pieces are in European languages, specifically Italian, French, German, and English.
Yes. 우리 학생 중에 제시카 모마니가 허버트 교수님한테 와서 왜 우리는 맨날 유럽 랭귀지만 하느냐고 좀 다른 걸 해보자고 해서 그래서 크리스가 우리는 주로 서양의 음악을 합니다. 그래서 다른 거는 좀 어려움이 많이 있어요. 그래서 하지만 그 제시카 모마니 그 학생의 아이디어로부터 이게 시작되었습니다.
So the more difficult part of the answer is that there's a bias in our field towards Western music, and this comes from our own pedagogical tradition. We're taught by our teachers, who were taught by their teachers, who were taught by their teachers. So there just becomes a resistance to a specific way of doing things, and why not break that now?
저희가 서양 음악을 계속 했기 때문에 그것에만 국한되어 있는 경향이 많이 있었어요. 그런데 우리가 이번에 그 전통을 좀 깨워보려고 이렇게 시도하는 것입니다.
Yeah. So breaching out into different languages is not only a challenge for all of our wonderful students, it's also a challenge for our faculty. So it's been a real adventure, and I'm very glad that we were passionate about expanding our boundaries both artistically and culturally.
네, 익숙하지 않은 말로 한다는 것이 학생들도 어렵지만 선생님한테도 굉장히 도전이 되었습니다. 하지만 우리가 이렇게 이 챌린지를 받아가지고 새롭게 이렇게 도전하는 것에 대해서 저희는 기쁘게 생각합니다.
So this amazing event all came about after I reached out to Professor Lim and I asked her opinion about the feasibility of introducing Korean language song to our students. And she was so enthusiastic about the idea and immediately came up with 30 different ideas of songs for our students.
네, 허버트 교수님이 저한테 물어보셨습니다. 이게 도대체 가능한 것인가? 그랬을 때 제가 너무 기뻐하면서 한 서른 가지 넘게 노래를 가지고 그것을 응집했습니다. 네.
And so then I reached out to my colleague Dr. Carrie Hong in the College of Education and suggested this idea and she wrote me back in 10 minutes and said this is exactly what I was hoping we could do at William Paterson.
그래서 허버트 선생님이 우리 홍은영 교수님한테 우리 윌리엄 패터슨 선생님이 교육과 그렇죠? 네, 교육과에서 교수님이신데 물어보셨어요. 그랬더니 선생님이 10분 만에 너무너무 좋은 아이디어라고 바로 대답을 하셨습니다.
And so thanks to Dr. Hong and also several other colleagues, we have Dr. Kumjae Park in sociology.
네.
We have Dr. Eunsun Park in communication disorders and Dr. Angie Yu in communication.
네, 여기 파워풀한 한국의 교수님들, 여자 교수님들이 계세요. 그래서 아까 홍영 선생님, 그다음에 유형원 선생님, 박은성 교수님, 그리고 박금재 교수님 많이 도와주셨습니다.
Mm-hmm. And because of this, we were able to establish a partnership with Cheongju University in South Korea, specifically with Professor Gunah Choi, who is an associate professor in education at Cheongju.
네, 선생님들의 도움으로 청주 대학교와 연결을 해서 최건아 교수님과 그 학생들과 함께 이렇게 같이 공동 작업을 하게 되었습니다.
And so what we did is we partnered our students, one William Paterson music student with one Korean education student in Cheongju. And our students met one-on-one three times over the course of the semester to get together about poetry, language, pronunciation, and interpretation.
그래서 저희가 청주 대학의 학생들과 안녕 짝을 지어서 지금 청주 대학의 이 짝꿍들이 청주 대학에서 보고 있습니다. 그래서 짝을 지어서 세 번을 만나서 언어와 그 문화와 여러 가지 그 곡의 배경에 대해서 같이 공부를 하면서 친구가 되었습니다.
And so the result has been a wonderful cross-cultural collaboration that has educated all of us in Korean culture and history.
그래서 결과적으로 우리가 한국의 문화에 대해서 많은 공부를 할 수 있는 좋은 기회가 되었습니다.
So this is now only going to be in English. This is how tonight is going to work. Okay, each of you has a program that details the order of the evening. Each student is singing one time with one of our fantastic staff pianists. The additional sheets include translations of the songs, most of which were completed by Dr. Hong, Dr. Park, Dr. Yu, and Dr. Park. Thank you so much for those. If you're performing, please make sure that you are backstage at least two songs before yours. So for example, if you're Yuanna, where are you, Yuanna? Ah, there you are. Then you want to make sure that you go backstage after Nicole sings. So yeah, at least two before. It's okay to leave, just make sure you leave during the applause, not while somebody is singing. And that goes the same if you're coming back. Don't come back in while somebody is singing. It's just distracting to everybody watching, including on YouTube live. So, just a bunch of thank yous before we begin. First, we need to thank a few specific people. First, Hannah Comia, June Marano-Murray, Soyeon Park, Charity Wicks, and our student, Kayla Hugmood, who are playing piano.
Staff하고 Charity Wicks, 그다음에 Hannah Comia, 그다음에 June Marano, 그다음에 오늘 같이 저랑 해주시는 박소연 피아노과 교수님 여러분께 너무 감사드립니다. Kayla Hogmood.
Yes. In addition, I want to thank our fantastic voice faculty: Darian Klontz, Sarah Griffiths, Juhyun Han, Tammy Petty, Jihyun Lim, and Sarah Wolfson.
And you?
And me.
Darian Klontz and Sarah Griffiths, Sarah Wolf and Tammy Patty. 전부 뒤에 앉아 계세요. 그리고 저 그리고 우리 크리스 허버트 박사님. 네, 감사합니다.
감사합니다. 주현, she's in the faculty room watching online stream.
네, 주현 선생님, 한주현 선생님은 오늘 또 노래도 해주십니다.
Exactly. And then, in addition, Dr. Hong, Dr. Park, Dr. Yu, and Dr. Park for their phenomenal support and work on the translations. It was so much work. Thank you.
네, 우리 박 교수님, 두 분 박 교수님, 박금재 교수님, 박은성 교수님, 그 다음에 홍은경 선생님, 교수님, 그 다음에 유경원 선생님, 감사합니다. 이 한국 시를 영어로 하는 번역하는 게 굉장히 어려워요. 그런데 선생님들께서 네 분께서 오랫동안 너무 열심히 준비해 주셔서 좋은 프로그램을 만들어 주셨습니다.
And then two of our students who did a pilot over the summer, Haley Longo and Owen Gavigan, who did so much work in August. In addition, their partners, Sohee Om and Damwon Lee over in Korea that worked
네.
with them.
은소희와 이담원 그리고 우리 헤일리, 헤일리 롱고와 그다음에 오은 게비겐, where is Owen? 네, 여름부터 이것을 준비하기 위해서 저희가 그 본무기로 하기 위해서 여름부터 이렇게 미팅을 하고 방학 때부터 준비를 했습니다. 감사합니다.
And then a super big thank you to Dr. Choi at Cheongju University and all of her students who helped us so, 네. so much. 네.
Thank you. 감사합니다. 최원아 선생님 감사합니다. 너무너무 수고하셨고요. 오늘의 읽기까지 도와주셔서 정말 감사합니다.
And finally, Professor Ji Cheong Lim, who put in so much dedication to make this possible. Okay, that was too long. Now we're getting started.
Shindare Coach by Dong Jin Kim. This song entails a man who loves his significant other very, very much, and he tells about how he will travel into the mountains and collect azalea flowers to lay a path for his lover.
Thank you. translates to Spring Maiden, and it's about this lovely, I consider it a nice little fairy. She's a nice little spring maiden, and she's wearing a grass piece of clothing. She's wearing pearl dew shoes. I don't have pearl dew shoes, but that's okay. And she's wearing a beautiful white cloud hat, and it's from the perspective of someone who's in their house, and they're really excited for spring to come, because who's not excited for spring to come? Winter hasn't even started. They're very excited, and they're wondering if they should go out and ask if spring is coming to them specifically. So, here's, without further ado, Om Chanyo.
Returning home after a foreign invasion and realizing your home doesn't feel like home anymore.
Thank you. be singing Where the Clouds Go. Where the Clouds Go is about a long-lost love, and the clouds in this song will guide you and reconnect you with that person that you're longing to see.
By Kim Dong-jin. This song is about a mountain in Seoul, Korea. I googled an image because I was like, oh, let me look this up. And it was the most beautiful mountain I've ever seen in my entire life. And this song is really powerful because the world's a terrible place sometimes. But you know, to remember the things that make us happy, like Cheongsan, is really important to move forward and live and be happy. You know? So that's what I feel like this song is about. Thank you.
Oh.
Flowering Clouds by Lee Cheongju. The translation roughly is that they're talking about these beautiful flowering clouds going from village to village, but then thinking about how sad it is when it's cold and they won't have things like that. But we're going to forget all of that. We're going to keep talking about the flowering clouds.
Oh, In 1954, after the Korean War, Park Hwa-mok returned to his home village to find it razed to the ground. This song depicts his old memories. My name is Timothy Burrell, and this is Boriba, as set by Yun Yong-ha.
Directly translating to Wooden Tombstone, Bimok is a song that lives in the heart of Korean people, as I remember soldiers who died anonymously on the Korean valleys and hillsides. Bimok embodies two crucial elements of Korean culture. First, a sense of darkness and sorrow carried from a long history of suffering, but simultaneously, a message of perseverance and hope for the future. I'd like to dedicate this song to my grandparents, Haemin and Harabaji, Mani Saranghaeyo.
Thank you.
Namcho. And Crane is about a crane, a very beautiful crane with a very long neck, very long wings. And one thing the song mentions is that the crane is so white it almost looks blue.
Jefferson, and I will be performing Boripiri, or Barley Straw Pipes, by Niam Cho. Boripiri is about a war veteran returning home, and as he walks through the fields, the barley straws sing through the wind, and they remind him of his village and the childhood that he had back then. I hope you enjoy.
Some more in the core, song, I am separated from my love because of the war. And each day I wait in anxious hope to see him walk over Arirang Hill so we can begin our lives together.
Translates to can never forget or unable to forget, and it talks about a man who loves somebody who doesn't love them back, and despite that he still misses them and just has to walk alone.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. my name is Ava Bonanno, and I will be singing Sarang, which translates to love, and the translation of the text is as follows. Burn your love into embers, but if you plan on only burning it halfway, don't bother burning it at all.
Translates to mountain village. The composer at the time of writing this, the only sight that he could see as he was ill and bedridden in a clinic was a mountain range, and it was the most beautiful thing that he saw. And it gave him hope that one day he would get out of this dark place and go to that mountain range. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you. Matthew Rodriguez. I'll be singing Gagopa by Don Jim Kim. Gagopa translates to I want to go home. Relatable. This is a song with a message of longing, yearning, and desperation. This is Gagopa.
Thank you. girl who's waiting by the riverside, wondering and longing for her lover.
Translated into longing is a song about a loss of love without notice. And so we go searching in nature for that same love just to find that we can't find it. So we go out running into the dark hoping for something better.
Thank you.
sing Setaron, which means bird song. So in this song, it's talking about a bunch of birds flying around, and it's from like the woodpecker to the owl. And yeah, and there's a really cool piano solo in the beginning, so enjoy.
Longing for Kumgang Mountain by Cheongju. Kumgang Mountain, with its 12,000 peaks, is the most beautiful mountain in Korea. However, it is located in North Korea and has been out of bounds to South Koreans for over 70 years. This song has two voices, the voices of South Koreans who long for and pine for Kumgang Mountain, and wonder if the beauty in its peaks is still there. And then there's the voice of Geumgang Mountain itself, who asks, will today be the day when all who want to come and see me will be able to find me again?
Thank you.
Thank you all. Before I describe what this song is about, I need to mention somebody I forgot in my opening speech. Eva Tobin is also one of our fantastic students. So, this song is called Nyeongtae, or dried pollock. I didn't know what a pollock was because we don't often eat it in American cuisine. It is a type of fish. It is a very, very small fish, and there's a lot of it. And it's in the Pacific Ocean, and you can find it at H Mart if you go to Manhattan. So in this song, I am a pollock, and I am describing how important I am to the cuisine of Korea, and how I will last forever. Because once you eat me, I will be with you. Forever.
Written by Mae Chang. Mae Chang was Giseng, who was not from the noble blood, but highly intelligent and a very artistic group of women, which will be equivalent of geisha in Japan and also courtesan in France. She wrote this poem, longing her lover who's gone by already. And it's just depicting beautiful that wet pear blossom is just falling. Okay, enjoy.
Woo!